Hey everyone, this is Nick. I'm coming to you today with a really quick trick on how you can directly label your legend or directly embed your legend into a clustered bar chart like this. This is going to work if you want your legend to be directly embedded like this, but you also want to have direct labels on your bars. So that's the 95%, the 90%, those labels on the ends of the bars. This means that you're going to get rid of the axis, you're going to get rid of the grid lines, and you want your bars to be directly labeled. You need to do a little bit of a workaround behind the scenes. Now, the obvious solution is to just put two text boxes on top of those bars. And honestly, 90% of the time, that's what I do. It's good enough and it's a nice brute force way to do it. But if you wanted a little bit more of an elegant, fun, kind of hacky solution behind the scenes, I've got you covered here. So we're gonna go ahead and escape out of this slide. And I'm going to show you, this is probably what you're used to seeing, a standard kind of default clustered bar chart right here with the legend over here on the right. This is what the legend would look like when it comes in the chart. I'm going to go ahead and just delete that legend because we don't need it. Now, what we need to do is we need to add a couple dummy series behind the scenes in our Excel pop-up. So we're going to right-click the data, say edit data, and now that Excel window is going to pop up right here. And what we need to do is we need to add a column here and we need to add a column here. So add a column in between 2024 and 25, and then add another column on the outside of 2025. So the first thing I'm gonna do is right click and see, and then I'm gonna insert, and that inserts a column directly to the left. And then over here, if I type something in this header, since it's a dynamic table, it'll automatically shift over. So I'm just gonna go ahead and say 2025. And now you can see that little caret, it pops up. And you can also see in my chart now, this chart actually now has space for four different bars, sets of bars. Because I don't have any data in these cells, nothing's gonna show up in that bar chart in terms of a colored bar. You can also see that since this is a dynamic table, Excel doesn't allow duplicate header names. So this 2024 became 2024-2. We don't want that. So what I'm gonna do in my original columns, I'm gonna go ahead and just say 2024 data. So I'm gonna make that something different. And then over here, I'm gonna say 2025 data. And then in column C, I'm just gonna change that back to my 2024, and column E, 2025. Okay, perfect. Now I don't need any numbers in these rows except for in the two cells that I want my labels to appear in. And I want them to appear on the top row in my chart, which means they're going to be the bottom row in my data source. Excel always does the backwards thing in charts. So in a chart, in a chart source range, the last row of data will always show up first on top of the chart and vice versa. Very confusing. So here I'm just gonna say, I'm gonna type whatever's in the cell next to it. So I'm gonna say 90% right here, and I'm gonna say 95% right here. You could do, 95% right there. It doesn't really matter. You could do any value. As long as it's probably more than 10 or 15%, because we want the label to show up inside of the base of the chart. So what we're gonna do now is you can see that these two bars showed up inside of my chart, the blue and the green. Right now we're gonna put labels on these bars. So right click, add label, and now, this one didn't actually show up. It looks up, there it is, right there, add label. So we have this 95% and 90% outside of those labels, or outside of those bars. Now what we're gonna do is adjust the position of those labels. So I'm gonna double click this label here to isolate it. The format data label menu should appear. If it doesn't, you're gonna right click and say format data label. And under the little column chart icon there, under label options, you can see that value is selected. We wanna go ahead and say select series name, and that puts the 2025 inside of this label. We're gonna unselect value. And then we're going to, under label position, we're gonna say inside base. And then I'm gonna turn the color, change the color of that bar to no fill so that it kind of makes it disappear. Now you can see that 2025 is right there on the base. Now I'm gonna do the same thing to this green bar here, or to the green label. We're gonna go ahead to that icon, the bar chart icon, series name, so 2024 appears, unchecked value, under label position, inside base, and then I'm gonna go ahead and click on that bar. We're gonna say no fill. And then here's the trick. I'm gonna go ahead and close out my data source. What we need to do is we need to move the labels, the 2025 and 2024 bar, we need to put those onto the secondary axis. So all we need to do in order to do that, the easiest way to do it, I find, I wanna see them all in succession. So what I'm gonna do is with my chart selected, go to the chart design tab and click on the change chart type. Now right now, my combo is selected. And you can see under combo, all of these chart types are set to clustered bar. if by chance you get this, one right here, it goes back to the clustered bar up here, and you have to go ahead and click on combo, you might get something like this, this clustered column and line thing. This is just, it's wild. Go ahead and just change all of these to bar chart. Change every single one of these to bar chart, clustered bar. So now it starts to kind of look the same, but you can also see that these secondary axis boxes, these boxes are selected. Just unselect all of them for now. And so that nothing is selected and everything is a clustered bar. So it looks just like this, just like I want. Now, what I said before, we're going to go ahead and put the label columns onto the secondary axis. So 2024, we're going to select secondary axis, and 2025, we're going to select secondary axis and push OK. Now you can see that my labels are right here on top of the bars. The secondary axis right here, I can go ahead and delete that. We don't need it. And now from here, it's just formatting. So I'm going to go ahead and update this to a bold. I'm going to change it to white and maybe 20 points. And let's go ahead and just use our format painter. Click on the format painter right here. I'm going to click on it once to activate it. And then I'm going to click on this label and it will format it just like I did before. Now, if I wanted to update the bar color, we can go ahead and do that. What I'm going to have to do though is, because I'm selecting this bar, it's actually selecting that dummy bar, the 2025 bar. I want to make sure that the orange bar behind it is changed to green. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click on this bar right here under educational, and that selects all of the bars that are on my primary axis. I'm going to go ahead and change that fill color to green, and now I have my perfect chart with an embedded legend and directly labeled bars. Pretty cool. A little tiny workaround. Again, the text box is right on top of that chart. Probably going to do just as good for you 90% of the time. But if you want that little workaround solution behind the scenes to make the chart a little bit more dynamic, that's the way to do it. Add those two extra columns and then put your legend in the chart just like this. So if you like this tip, give it a thumbs up. And I hope you hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.